A big challenge in sanitation is building and maintaining toilets in villages because of limited resources, limited manpower, and high transportation costs. But this engineer saw these problems as an opportunity to create new solutions. He set up WhatSan to tackle last-mile challenges in water and sanitation through technology.
A decade ago, I visited more than 2,000 villages across Tamil Nadu, where I wanted to photo document the dilapidated temples, wherein I found the problem of water and sanitation lacking. So this made me start WhatSan, as the name indicates, water and sanitation.
For sanitation, they focus on the problem of constructing toilets without depleting river sand or a lot of water. Chandrasekharan then started looking for a better raw material. Huge amounts of fiberglass from the windmill industry are discarded, which then end up in landfills. Sadly, there are no takers for this. They upskill this waste fiberglass as building material for their toilets. Tiruturai Pundi is one village in Tamil Nadu where WhatSan's toilets have been constructed, where they trained a group of women to do so. Chandrasekharan and his team have made it possible for the people in an area to construct toilets themselves by providing affordable molds and raw materials. But sanitation is just one pillar of public health. There are all kinds of challenges when it comes to drinking water in the country. In the northeast, there's arsenic in the water, which causes cancer. In Rajasthan, Telangana, and parts of Karnataka, there's fluoride in the water, which leads to fluorosis and bone diseases. It's not that there isn't enough water, but there isn't enough clean drinking water. To tackle this, they developed a water purifier that does not need electricity to run, and so it can be used anywhere. The filtering component is a special nano clay candle with micropores to remove microbes, heavy metals, and turbid water. The most important factor in making the clay candles is the selection of ingredients such as clay and sawdust. A candle goes through a 13-day cycle of mixing, soaking, drying and burning before it is taken out of the kiln. The candles are then bundled and shipped to the Chennai office, where it is assembled with an antibacterial cementing material into the plastic holder to fit into the filter. The purifiers are used by the Border Security Force and during natural disasters. For their contribution to water and sanitation in India, Chandrasekharan has won several awards. But he is not done yet.